Hello and welcome to another Nico Media Tutorial. So today we will make one of my last things. This one here, this RGB logo thing here, looks like this. And I got immediately a lot of questions about it. And this is similar to, I had to make this logo for a client. This is not the same logo. So I've spoken with my client and he said, okay, this I changed it enough so I can show it with this, and I can show it for my people. And the hard thing on the really hard part was not the lightning or the something else. It was the model, this shape. This was, I really had a hard time to think about how I could model this shape. And yeah, so let's start to model this. And I have it here, so Shift F6. So a little smaller here. So, and I tried it with a sweep knob and everything, so I made this the whole spline but this does not work. The sweep knob, it twists it and then rotates, and then you have just troubles with it. So then I thought, yeah, how do I do this? And I found a way, a little sweep and then bring all together. And yeah, it looks quite easy maybe, but it will take some time. So yeah, and I will render this in Octane. This is done in Octane, but it is exactly the same in as I tell it every time, the same in for the physical render. The material creation is almost the same in Octane. It's more difficult than in the PR. This project file is already available for patrons on my Patreon site, and there you will find a version for the physical render too. So with the materials for the physical render too. I will show you for the physical very short thing how you can make this light here and everything. But first let's model this. Modeling is in Octane and physically of course the same. So let's model this thing. So what we need is first three rectangles. So one rectangle, two rectangle, three rectangles. So and imagine this is rotated 45 degrees. So when we go back 45 degrees in this y-axis here, we have one on the left upper side, one on the laying on the floor, and one down this y-axis. So let's make this three, and let this open here so that we can have. Let's make three rectangles. I make these blinds, and let's see this 100 by 100 by 100 100 100 100 100 100. Okay, good. Then I make another one, so I control drag it down, so I copy this one is this here. So then we need one of this, so rotate 90 degrees this direction, and one, I copy this again, and one we have to lay down on the floor, so this. Okay, that means this one on the floor should go to here. So E for move tool, and we have 100 by 100, so I move it 50 centimeter in this direction. Hold your shift key to get increments, and 50 in this, so I have it here on the floor. This one should be in the left upper corner here, so I go to this one, 50 centimeter to here, and 50 centimeter up, and this one down here. So I go with this 50 centimeter down, and 50 centimeter. So we have this now. And now imagine, let's put this all in a null, and we rotate this null 45 degrees. We have this shape. So this is this one is this one. This one here is this one here, and this one here is this one here. Okay, so far so good. Bring it out of here. So now I make Bring it in a backup folder. A copy of them, maybe we need it later on. I don't know. Good, and let's save this whole thing immediately. So kind of hearted. And then temp and the say RGB logo. RGB logo. Okay. Good. Now I make all of them editable. So I hit select all and hit C on the keyboard. And now I need just these sides here of the rectangles here. So just delete the middle points here of all of three. So I go into point mode, rectangle selection, and then in the rectangle selection, so we don't need this for now. The rectangle selection, I say, only select visible elements is off. So when I select here in the middle the points, we should have 3 points here, you see? I have 3 points. If you want to have this hub, this HUD thing too, go with Shift V in your viewport setting, and here in the HUD you can select whatever you want. And you see I have the selected points, selected edges, and selected polygons. Okay, and now I simply delete these 3 points here. So hit delete, and I get this. And now with my three splines, I don't close my splines. You see, okay. Looks a little bit. I want it in all back to. I have it now 45 degrees rotated, so I go back to here. Until here, okay. Make the same again, so backup folder. Copy of them in the backup folder. Convert it and delete the points in the middle. So now I don't want to close this plan. I have it here. This one is okay, this one is okay, but this one looks a little weird. So I take this 1 point here and say set first point, and okay, now we have the same here. It's nice, and so far so good. With all three of them selected, or the spline selected, I put them in a sweep NURBS. So I go to the sweep, I hold my Alt key, with all three selected, hold my Alt key, and now I have everyone in a sweep, you see. Now I make a rectangle, this is the profile spline for our sweep, so this is 30 by 5, should be fine. Drag it in this sweep, and yep, this looks nice. Copy of this rectangle in this sweep and another copy in this sweep. I don't want caps here on the sweeps. So I select all three sweeps. Caps, known, known. Fine. So far. Now I can make this guy's editable. Go to all my sweeps and hit C on the keyboard. Good. Nice, nice, nice. So now comes the fun part. What I want is I want to connect this one with this one, so on this side, so on this downside here, from here to here. This will be one of these banded connections. But now we are not overlapping. We need that all our guys here overlap a little bit. So we have 30 height here, and so I want 30 centimeter overlapping. That means I have to go with this one 15 centimeter in this direction and 15 centimeter down, and with everyone I have to go 15 centimeter to the middle point. I hope that makes sense. So I take this one, go to 15 centimeter to the middle and down 15 centimeter. I hold my key, my shift key. I have my increments to 5, the default is 10. And if you want to change this, go to the mode, modeling settings, and here you have the quantize, you see. Here you can change this. The default is 10, and I have everything at 5. Okay, then I go to this one. 15 centimeter and 15 centimeter up. And the last one, 15 centimeter in this direction and 15 centimeter in this direction. So that means it overlaps now everywhere. We have here 15 overlapping in this direction, 15 in this direction means in the middle, from here to here and from here to here, we have 30. Now we need just some cuts. I go to this guy and let's see if we can make this easy. We cannot use a loop cut. KL wouldn't work here. You see, that does not work. We need a straight cut. So with KJ, I can make a plane cut. Let's say local. And I want it via X, yes. And to make a cut here. So now when I UL this cut, so UL is a loop selection. I'm in the X axis is 30. But it looks weird, but I want it E. And when I go to here, 30. This is not 30. Good, we do it differently. So with MN I can delete this cut here. MN. MN is dissolve. You can right click and dissolve. If you have something to dissolve, it would be here. It is called dissolve. What I make is I make a loop selection UL here. And this MO is a slide tool. And I hold now my control key, you see here. I hold my control key, and if I hold my control key, it's the same way when I say here clone. I hold my control key and drag this guy, this, you see here, we have it now, this edge, which I selected, and say here minus 30. Okay, that's nice. The same I do on the bottom here. Make a loop selection, UL, MO for slide, and hold my control key and slide this guy up to minus 30. This is the 30 degrees, the 30 centimeter we need. This is 30 centimeter because we have this rectangle here, this is 30 centimeter. This was our profile spline from the sweep. Okay, and now I'm too, you know, I'm lazy, and so I'm too lazy to cut the other ones too. So, and because we should have here our axis centered normally. Let's see if it's really centered. Go to center axis. And now it's centered. Okay, let's center all the axes. I do this with the magic center from a Nitro Man. But if you don't have, this is a free plugin, the link is in the description. If you don't have this, you simply can go, I have this here in the axis center. You will find it here under somewhere. Under mesh axis center, you find it here. And if you do this, you have everything at zero and then just hit execute or auto update and execute. Then you have the same. So now it's everything is centered. So that means I make a copy of this guy here, the first sweep. Control, drag it under this sweep here. And here I say simply reset PSR. This means reset position, scale and rotation. That means it takes exactly the same position like this one here. This one is this guy. And reset PSR, I have it here in my toolbar. You will find it as well. I think it's under character commands. It was under commands. The easiest way is you hit Shift C and then you get this command line and type in reset PSR and you have it. Double click on it. But I have it here in my toolbar. So I select this and say reset PSR. You see, it is exactly on the same position but in the other rotation, but this is no problem. I can rotate and rotate this 90 degrees and I must have the same position. So go out of this and delete this guy. The same I do here with this control bracket under it, with set PSR, you see, rotate it how I need it, and delete this guy, whoops. So, don't have to make cuts. And now I can connect this polygon with this polygon. This would be the first rounding. Then we can connect more. We can connect this polygon with, yeah, we have to see it. This, then this with this. Let's bring this in with a set. This is quite complex. Yeah, of course, this polygon with this polygon here, and this polygon with this polygon. But later, not now. Now what I do is, I close the holes what we opened before. We said in the sweep we said no caps, please, because the caps were triangles. So this was the reason I wanted. I didn't want it. What I do, I take all of them and make a copy and track this in the backup. So now I take all of them and make a connect and delete. You can right click, connect and delete. It's here, connect object and delete. And I have it here in my toolbar, connect object and delete. So this is all now one object. This is exactly what I want. So I select it, polygon mode MD. MD is for close polygon hole. And I close this polygon hole, close this one, close this one, close this one. Close this one, and let's close this one. Good so far. Now I want to select something. I want to select all the edges they want to connect. I want to connect. So this is this one, all the polygons, and this one. Hold the shift key to add the selection. I want to select this one, shift key, and this one, and I want to select this one with this one. Okay, nice. And now I simply extrude this. So I say D for extrude, D, and I want to extrude them 30 degrees, 30 centimeter. It's the same as 30. We have everywhere 30, so 30. And I want another extrusion. So I say here on the D, no, on the tool, so new transformation. So I get another one. Okay, this is exactly what I want. Looks weird, but it's exactly what I want. Now I have to connect some points. First, now I wanted to delete all the polygons I had here. Yeah, you will see. First we close the polygon hole and then now we delete it again. Yeah, we could have done this with the edge selection too, but it does not work sometimes. So I delete, just hit delete, and all the polygons are gone. Good. Now I want this point and this point. I want to connect these two points. And then I want to connect these two points, then the outer. I think it's easier when we make this an X-ray here. Yeah. So I go in point mode. And the rectangle selection. Tolerance, the only select visible is off. But here you have to be a little careful. So I want to select this point here, and connect them together. So I take this point here, and this point. Here I look at my points. Okay, two points selected. This is exactly what I want. Now I hit MQ, and you see I have a point here in the middle. It's exactly what I wanted. So just click somewhere. Okay, that's what I want. Now and again, select this one and this one, MQ. Okay, now I select this one here and want to connect it with this one. And last but not least, this one with this one. Thank you, Chuck. Okay, now we have a connection between these guys here. Now I go in Edge mode, UL by loop selection, select this guy here, E for the move tool, and I see, okay, that it does not does not go in the correct direction, this axis. So I go to my modeling axis here. So when you hit E or click on your move tool, you get this modeling axis thing. And here I go from axis to normal. Now I can drag this in here, so let's see, 15 centimeter. Okay, and you see this is a little narrower than this one, or smaller. So I hit T for scale and scale this up here. Let's see, I hold my shift key again to have increments. This 135 looks nice. Nice, we have the first connection here. Now let's do the same with this guy here. So, it's a little you have to concentrate a little bit, but this is done in minutes, so just here you have to go through. You want to connect this point with this point, and be careful that we have two points just. MQ again, and connect these guys. Again, this and this one. MQ, back, okay. Then, yeah, with the space bar, you can toggle between the last two used tools. So that means I have now this, what is this MQ? This is weld. Okay, so with the spacebar, I toggle between weld and now spacebar, rectangle selection, spacebar, weld, rectangle selection. So you can toggle between, that's the nice thing here. So I select this, hold the shift key and select this guy here, 2 points, spacebar to toggle. Okay, again, here and here. Whoops, nice. Edge UL for a loop selection, E for the move tool, move it down 15 centimeter, scale it up with T 135 and done. And now this is the last one. Let's go again in my point mode, rectangle selection, whoops, whoops, MQ. Okay, so MQ, then this one and this one, MQ, and this one, MQ. That should work, yep. Edge mode UL, so E, whoop, 15 centimeter, scale it up, 135. And that's it. This is almost a modeling tool thing. Okay, so now we can go out of this X-ray. We have this now. But if we put this, let's save it. If we put this in a subdivision surface, it looks like this. So this is not what we want. Yeah, normally I would say I've put this in a simple bevel deformer, and this everything is beveled, yay. Now, yeah, looks in the first case here, but look at here, bleh. And you can do whatever you want. So first I go to my solid here, and go to uniform. It does not work with this bevel deformer. We have to make our own cuts. So the cut orgy starts. Good, edge mode. So we have to cut everywhere on the edges with the loop cut. This is a nice thing here. It looks a little weird, but you will see it's quite nice. KL is the loop cut mode. So you see, if I go now to here, I have a cut from here down to here, and down from here to here, and this is exactly what I want. So I go and start with this guy here. Make a cut here. As closer you go to the edge here, as sharper your edge will be at the end with the subdivision. So I go with something like this here. This is just a feeling. It I don't make it exactly. You could make it exactly with the slide tool or something else, but I make it by eye. So I eyeball it. So okay, one cut, another cut, and a third cut. I need three cuts for a nice edge here. And if you have something like a cube here, then you know it's correct. Same I do on the other side. Here and here I have something like a cube too. And if I make this now, you see, we have a perfect edge here. That's exactly what we want. But of course, we have to do it more often now. Maybe you're saying, okay, this is my new logo, so then you are ready. Good. Make here more subdivision that looks just nice. So, okay. And an eye for the isoparms, so we see our nice mesh. It looks nice like this too. So, but we make it correct. So I make it everywhere where I have this hard edge and no diagonal thing here. So then this plateau thing. So the next one I do here. And here I see, okay, here I need just a cut here. And I have my cube here. Here the cube is done. Okay, we are ready here. Where is the next plateau? Here down or here? Here, this is the same. Let's go to here. Cut, and you see, we need here a cut. Now we have the cube. That's okay. Here, simply cut here. We have a cube, so that should work. Where do we have another one? So here. Oops. And here, so, cube, nice, so, we're almost done, here, cube here, so, that's nice, and the good thing here is we immediately see where we need to do something and where not, just, and now I see, okay, around this works, but here we don't need some help. Okay, and the next thing is here. We need three lines, so three edges. We have here one edge, let's make it like this here. We have one edge, two edges, and we need here a third one. Three edges, so interior cut, and then we have here little cubes again. So KL again, so I make here a cut, and here a cut. Now I see I have here something like a cube, here something, and here I need another one, I see, because here we have three, but here we have one, two, we need a third one, so, third one, so this is okay, and if I make now this, we have a wonderful edge here, look at this, it looks perfect. Same we need to do here, you see we have here just two cut, so that means we need here a third one. Whoop, okay. And here we need a third one too. Come on, so here we need a third one. Okay. Here we have one, two, and we need a third one. And here we have only one, so here we need two, we need here a cut, and come on. Sometimes it's a little playing, closer. So, okay, here we have just two cuts, need a third one, and here we need one and here another one, so we have three of them. Okay, and here we need a third one too, so believe me, when you do this more often you get used to it, so it's it in the beginning it may look complicated, but it is not really. So we have everywhere these three cuts, yep. Looks nice. And when you do this more often, you see it. You see immediately, here is a cut. And if you don't know what you do, so just now I see, okay, everything looks nice except these diagonal parts. But this looks nice too, so this could be your model if you want. But we want the diagonals too, so they are very easy to handle. We make a loop cut here. We need to, again, three edges. You see, one, two, three. Go to the next diagonal part here. One, two, three, so. And do the last one here. One, two, three, okay. Now we should have everything cut it. So, look at this. We are ready. And we have a wonderful mesh. Perfect mesh, perfect model. Can't do it better. Okay. Yeah, faster than I thought. And half an hour for this thing is a good one. But we are not ready, of course. We have to make these light things and everything. And I want this thicker, so because we have this here thicker, so I'm gonna need this light stripe here. This will be an own thing. So good. Now there is one. Kind of, if you say this is too sharp for me or not sharp enough, this edges. There is a little thing what you can do. This is this Pi Extrude modifier. You will find the link in the description. This is from the Maxon Labs, so don't search in the description for Pi Extrude modifier. You search for Maxon Labs, and then you go to Maxon Labs, and there you can download the whole modifier things here, and they are free. So nice things. Good. I don't need the extrude modifier. I don't need the inner modifier. They are not in my layout here, so I have to go to here. Parametric tools. This no, not normal scale. I think the scale modifier I need here. I hold my shift key. Scale modifier. Okay, bring the scale modifier under the sweep. Okay. And now, normally, when I make this up. And I go to my scale modifier and go up. You can make this a little smoother, everything, you see. So you can make this afterwards. Or you can even make it sharper, but don't go over, you see. Then, and this does nothing different, but because it shifts the edges a little, you think, you see. So, but I don't need this here, maybe a little bit. Let's see, I don't know now, maybe later. Okay, but I want to have this whole thing. Oh, let's see. This is, it's oh, I think here we've got something here. Huh? Yeah, here you see we've got one cut here. But this is very easy, KL, loop cut, whoops, done. Now, yep, now it looks like it should look good. So, back to this guy, I think. And I want this whole thing now a little thicker. For this, I can go to my sweep knobs, go to my polygon selection, and UN is a Phong selection tool. And when I select this, go to here. You see, I select just the outer parts and not the edges here. This is exactly what I want. I will save this selection, so I set selection. I have it here in my toolbar, and this stores my selection here. And if you don't have it in your toolbar, you go to select and here you have set selection. Okay, nice. What I want now is, I want to make this, I could do now here a D for extrude and no caps, be careful, no caps, and extrude this out, as you see, so I can make this a little thicker. But when I'm not sure how far I want to go, so I go back with this and I have this selection and I need another pie thing. Pie parametric, and this is the shift modifier. So I have the shift modifier and see what this does. It works everywhere, but I want it just on this selection tag, so I restrict it to this selection. And now I can play with this and can say when I'm saying, okay, now I like it, and then I use it. But I think first I will make the edge a little rounder here. Bring this up so that this works first. You see? I have a little edge. Let's go to 90 here. Okay. Go down with this. Make this sweeten up here. And make now current. You can make current state to object to make an object out of it. Or what I do is I just use my edit optimize script. The link is in the description. And check. Yes, I want to optimize it. So now I have this state, and now I bring this back down here. So let's see if this works. But we have to bring in again selection tag. Okay, nice. 2 centimeter looks nice. And I want this part from here to be my light stripe then. Or no, I just want this middle part here. This is just for the rounding. Okay. I would say the thickness is okay. I am happy with this. Again, I make it editable. So edit optimize. Yes. Now, I don't need this selection tag anymore, polygon mode, UL, and I want to select the part where my light comes in. You see, with UL I have exactly all the edges selected, because we have a very nice mesh flow here, and so it works everything exactly how we need it. And now D for extrude, and I extrude this down like centimeter or so. Be careful that you don't go over, don't overshoot here. So, but the centimeter should be fine here. So, it should work everywhere. Yeah, that looks good. Good. And now I wanna with UP I wanna split these polygons from the original object. So UP is split. Now I get this one, and this is only this thing here, the polygons we had. Okay, hooray. What I do now is, of course I want to go up again with this thing, so that we are on the same level at the end here. But now first I go here, select all my polygons. With Control A you can select all the polygons. And D for extrude, and we know it's 1 centimeter here. So D for extrude, and I want to extrude it just the halfway. So I go to 1.5 and 0.5. You see it here, 0.5. And I want to close the caps here. Okay, this is the first step. What I do now is I go to my edge mode, UB. UB is a ring selection. And it selects all the edges along this thing. And with MM, I cut all these edges in half. So MM, you see, MM. And now with UL, I select this one here. And this will be the spline for our sweep nerves, which gets the emission color. So this is our pass for our sweep nerve. And I do this on the halfway because it should be in the middle of this frame here, in the middle of this part. So I have it now in the middle of the part, and then I go another 0.5 up. So this spline is exactly in the middle. And what we have to do now is, of course, make a spline out of this. This edge, with the edge selected here, we simply hit edge to spline. I have here this, and you have it, I think, under mesh commands, edge to spline. Here you have it. And then we get this spline. And this is exactly what I want to bring it out here and say this is my light stripe. Okay. On this one, this edge I can dissolve again. So MN or right click and somewhere it says dissolve. MN, you see? MN, this shortcut is from R19 or something. I think earlier it was not there. So, bye bye. So I have this is what you see is my spline here. And now I go back to my sweep here and again, D for extrude, but be careful. Now we don't want caps in extrusion. And extrude it another 0.5. So apply, and we are exactly here where we should be. And in this one here now, you will see it. I go to here and make this X-ray. Make the light stripe here. You see exactly in this object we have our spline. And this is exactly what we want. And then out of this spline we make a sweep nerve. See, it works perfect. Cool. So, yep. Out of the thing here. So, and now the next thing is, let's go to my subdivision surface here. We shift, I click on the null object, I make a new null object, put all these paths in the null object here, so in the null object. And now this subdivision surface affects everything what is in this null here. So that means when I now send in, you see what we get. Exactly what I want. Okay, this looks a little too round for me. This is no problem too. Go to this one, edge mode. Hide our UL for loop selection here and here. Again, I'll store this selection with set selection. Under the sweep, I want the bevel deformer. Whoops. And in the bevel deformer, I bring in the bevel deformer options, the selection deck here. And this is far too big. So, but first, I want a solid. And here in the offset, I want to go. Hold your Alt key to have increments of 0.1. And you see here, I can go down as far as I want. And now in my subdivision surface, now I have it sharper. Bring this again to here. We wouldn't see it, but we know that it's there. So. Okay. Save this. And we are now we come to the end. That makes really so I don't know how you see it, but I think this is really fun. Good. We could start. No, let's first let's make the sorry. Let's make the sweep. So not the sweep, so this is the logo. This is the light stripe, okay, and then we need the sweep for the light stripe. Nothing easier than that. So let's hide this for the moment. Bring back our thing here, so we need a small circle, let's say 0.4, something else. Here I go to the uniform and four. Don't need so many. You see, it's just I don't need many. I have four wicket constants, three. So this is enough. I don't need a totally round circle here. I don't see this. Good. Bring the circle in a sweep with the Alt key on the sweep. Point with the circle selected. Shugung. And we have our sweep here. And this should fit with this one here. Looks correct so far. I see it's exactly inside it, where it should be. Okay. But one problem we have, and this is the following. Let's see this. Okay. Let's hide this one here. So we see our sweep here. When I make the subdivision surface on, you will see the sweep goes not with it, of course. Let's see, maybe we can see this. Now it works. Now it is exactly the same as everything. But it seems that it's here. Nope, we have everything is correct now. Good, done. Save this, and now let's start to do something with this. First thing I want to do, I want to put everything in a null object. Make a null, we're doing, put it inside. This is the whole object. And I rotate this 45 degrees. Good, nice. And I bring it on the floor. Here is a nice drop to floor. The object is selected and everything that is in this object will be dropped to the floor, you see? Perfect. The link for this is in the description, of course. People always ask me, do you write so many links in the description? Of course, there are many links in the description. There are many to download and we use a lot, so there has to be a lot inside. But honestly, most of the people don't read it. So, okay, done. So we can start. We need materials. First, I make a normal material, a metal material here. I use my own material pack here, but you can use the normal material, so you have a metal, octane metal, metallic material here. But I go to my live database. It needs always a little bit to open, so okay. See, I have a Nicomedia thing. This is for to download for patrons. From 5 euros and above, they can download my packs, and I update it. I know I updated in a longer time, not because I don't need. I just update it when I need a new material. But there are so many. I almost don't need other materials. But if I do new materials, they will be updated, and you can download it, of course. So metal, real metal. So, and I use here the iron download. And I will show you how this looks. I can close it. This is a very, very simple thing. So, now that it. This is here. This is the rough. This is at zero. And the spectrum is at black. And here is just in the basic. It's metallic GGX. The only thing what's here what makes it a real metal is the IOR values here. So yeah, but you don't need this really. So if you don't need, you can work with the artistic one too. But you see immediately that it looks not the same. But the metallic you can do it, and you will find these values on the net. You just search for IOR values, and you will come to a site which has every values you need. So okay. This is first this, but we need, of course, a little roughness on it. Whoops. Make this a little smaller. But when it's smaller, then it starts to be unsharp somehow. Bring this on our logo. And let's see what we get. Save. And let's see what we get here. We should get something. Immediately we get a nice thing. But we have now nothing what reflects in the scene or something else. Yeah, we have the logo itself, which reflects inside itself. So this, yes. But to make it a little nicer, I will bring in first my Octane rig. You see, that looks immediately nicer. Okay, this is a little boring maybe. So we need some scratches, I need. And I have my scratch map here. I'll drag it inside. Okay, come in. This looks like this. This is my scratch map here. When in the project file, this is included. So if you download the project file on Patreon, this is included. So make here some space. Whoopsie. Okay. This here, I will put this first in the bump channel. This. Whoop, and we will see what we get. First thing what I see, we have the wrong mapping. No problem, let's go to our texture deck here and go from UV mapping to a cubic mapping. Looks better. I right click on the texture deck here and say fit to object. Yes. Good, but this is far too much. This is nothing. So how can we bring this down? In this bump material we don't have, like in the physical render material, you have a percent. You can say I'm on 5%, 10% bump. We don't have this here. We do it here with the color correction. Bring in the color correction. And then for the brightness, I take a float texture. So, and when I go down with the float here, you will see, you get less bump. This looks nice. But I don't want just bump, I want it a little dirtier, a little darker on this one. So what I can do is now, I can take the same image texture with the correction node and bring it into the specular map. Let's see if this does something. This is too much. Okay. But I want it in the specular map. So what I have to do is I make another color correction and float texture. So maybe I can take this too and copy it with the control key. Bring it in the specular map here. The texture in here. And with the float texture here, I go up. Now you see we get dark parts here. And if it's too dark for me, I go to the color correction and play with the gamma, go down with the gamma a little bit. Yes, now this is what I like. Maybe the scratches are a little too bigger, now they look quite good, but you can go to your image texture here, UV transform. I don't know why the transform node goes somewhere. Why does the transform node go to here? What else? And I go down here a little bit with the lock ratio and go make it a little smaller. Yeah, that looks better. Don't go too far because then you start to see the a repetition, you see? So, but 0.5 or something should work nice. Yeah, that works nice. Good. We have a nice material here. And you see, it's not really complicated. So. Fine. Next step, we need the light. Yeah, let's make the light. So for the light, I want an emission material. So I do delete this sweep here, and I want to see just this one, this sweep here. It's okay. So for this sweep, I need just a diffuse material. So open it in the node editor. Because the only materials who have an emission channel is the diffuse material and the specular material. The glossy material does not have emission, so that's the reason I use this. And here I need a black body emission. Bring it under the emission here. And bring this whole thing on our sweep. Look at here. And immediately we have a little problem with my rig. This is the one of the only things where I have to find a solution. This will come in the next update. but we will do another thing later on. Let's go to the thing and turn the background on. And I do this in later another background. But let's make this a little darker here. So. Okay. Good. Okay. There is a fix to do this. So when you say visible on diffuse off, then you see we get an infinite flow. But that looks not so nice with the light. But for now we can do it like this or with this. But more is question is, I think, how make this lights. Well, this is a little much here. So. Good. We need a gradient, of course. In the gradient, I want a very. And so make this up and load the preset, this full color preset. And I need the V direction here. And put it in the texture. Tukung. And look what we have. What we get? We get this nice thing here. But I want to see the I want a smaller gradient, so I go to my light tag here, so the texture tag, and say here in the tiles, let's go to 10. Now you see we have this nice thing. So, and now I show for the physical render guys how you make this material or how you do this in the this is it is the same in the physical render. So I make a new material, make just for an example here two circles. So this circle will be 10. 20 is enough, and here 20 is enough too. Okay, make here a sweep. So, okay, we have this sweep. Ah, make it 10. So, okay, make a new material. I need just the luminance channel. In the luminance channel, bring in a gradient. The same again in the V direction. Load the preset, full colors, drag it on the sweep, boop, done. Here the same, 10, we have this, and you animate this thing simply with this offset here. That's it. More is not to do here. You see how easy this is. This is. And if you want it brighter, of course, it goes here to multiply, and then you go up with the brightness to wherever you need it, you see. Okay, so you see how easy it's much easier than in Octane. Okay. This was just to show it here. Good. We have now this. This is, we need a better background here. What I do and use the Octane rig for the camera now. I do it not so often, but here it's perfect. Go to my camera, activate it here. Bring, okay. Bring it, CDF, bring, oh, this is up down. I bring it with CDF, bring it to me a little. Hello, baby. So. Okay, rotate my object a little bit. You see, I cannot rotate it now. Here, the axis is wrong, so I go here to the world axis. The shortcut is W, so world axis. And drag it a little to the side, so that looks fine. Okay. And so have this now. And I want another thing in the background. We could use, what could we use? We could use whatever we want. Let's bring in a stage object. So, first I deactivate here my floor. Background and floor, shadow capture off. So, and I bring in the Nikon Media Scenery, doesn't matter the Pro or the Ultimate version, we will find a L Studio. So, yeah, this Studio L here. Bring this in. But you can do this very easy by yourself. It's just a banded plane, nothing else. And, but here I have some user data on it, so that we can play a little bit with it. So, okay, this looks nice so far, but I have to go with my stage. We have here now some XY scale. I go with the Y up here, and I can go even further. So, and the C is enough. Let's see. Let's see now. See, sir. And then so we have this one here. And here we have this material on it, so we don't need the original material. Make a glossy material. Going and open the node editor and tell it you are the studio. Okay, bring it on my studio. Good so far. I see we have here immediately some nice reflections and everything, but I want a dark diffuse here, so dark background. And it's, of course, it's totally too much glossiness. Roughness is nice here, maybe less. And I don't want the white thing here. So, what we can try is a fall off here in the sheen. Let's see what we get here. Yeah, that looks immediately better. Okay. And maybe less specular. A float here. Yeah, now I use another HDRI. This, of course, this HDRI is not the nicest, so I go to my scene rig, HDRI, Shift F6, Shift F8, not F6. Okay, HDRIs indoor, and which one did I use? I think I use this one here. Gong. Yeah, that looks nice. I see. to find a spot where we don't have too much background things. Yeah, that looks nice. And then let's go to here again. Full of map. Let's try a sheen here with a float texture. Float. It definitely does something, but I don't know if it does the same. But go to the studio IOR. Yeah, that looks better. Yeah, we are done more than less. So I'm not sure what I'd like more here. This is okay. But it makes not really. No, it makes it better. But it looks not bad like this, I think. Ah, you know what we can do? We have. You see, this is very close to the studio. I go back with my studio. That will do it. That will make it better. So, and of course now I need it in the X. Okay, Y is enough, I think. No, it doesn't matter. Okay, let's see too. Okay, and here we have a very small curve. We can change this with the offset here. Yeah, that makes it much better. A little rounder. It makes it much better. Oh, I'm not in the flow anymore. So. Okay. I think we are done. So let's try this again. Yeah, now it looks better. Maybe a little more. Where is our light here? So, and go up with the light, yes. That's great. And here, of course, this here you can play with the post effects too. So, oops. Come back here. Let's go to our rig here. Camera. Post processing on. And we can play here. But maybe not the glare. With the bloom. Yeah, that's our octane. Studio, and again, node editor. Yeah, so we have more contrast. Nice. Maybe we can make. What do I have when I make here? Specular. Huh? Looks definitely different. I have to do more with this fall off things. I do not enough with it. I don't know. So it's more or less. I want more. Okay, that's nice. Maybe even more roughness. Because it's not bad in the background, but somehow it could. Now it's better. Now it's much better. And to get rid of this reflections in the here in the curve, we simply should be able to take another HDRI or try it with another angle here. Yeah, this HDRI has too much lights in it, too much small lights. You see this is has a lot of small lights in it. Let's try another one. Something like, I like this normally. That's a little dark. Oh, nice. Yeah, this, I like this shines, so this is nice. Maybe, oops, not the way. Okay. Maybe a little less. Let's see with the brightness. No, is it? And of course, I can do this then in post work in After Effects or DaVinci Resolve or something else. And yeah, now it's nice. That's nice. So I make some frames, a test render for some frames, so that we see it works. So what we need is we need to rotate the thing. So okay, to animate the lights here, I showed you this is very easy thing. Go to here and animate this offset here. Give us 200 frames here. And here is something. When you slowly, let's move the lights. We won't see it really that they move because of the rotation of the object. If it's still, of course you see it. And so I made it a little faster. So I made an offset here from zero, frame zero to frame 100, and frame 100 I go to 100%. But normally, I want the rotation of the thing 200 frames. So what I have to do is, this would stop after 100 frames, it would stop to move. So here is a thing it can do. Go to your animation F curve, you see, yep, we have our F curve. And what I say is now, after this 100 frames, just continue like it is. So you go to your offset here, click on this offset, and then you get here an after. Here's constant, and I go to continue. And then you see, it simply continues until the end. But it's double to the speed, like I would say 100% at 200 frames. So, okay, and now let's rotate our object. This should be easy, But I don't want to start this. I like this position here, but I don't want to make the null plus 360 or something else. I make a new null, bring it in, and bring this object inside the null, and this is just a rotate null. So, and now I can start with zero. Okay, we have, let's say, when you have 100 frames and you want this 360 thing looping. That means the last frame is not at 360 degrees because the 360 would be zero, and so you would have two frames the same position, and this we don't want. So normally I do just, I say on frame 100, 359, but this is not really correct. So if you want to make it correct, so you think like this 100 frames, 360 degrees. So that means per frame 3.6 degrees. And nothing easier than this. I have to go on frame 100, 360 minus this 3.6 degrees. So, and for 200 frames, of course, it's the double, so I need the half of this is 1.8. So, what I will say is, so on frame 0, I make the heading here, okay, and then frame 200 is 360 minus 1.8 because we have 200 frames. If you would have 100 frames, it would be minus 3.6. Okay, now we have it exactly. Now we have this here, and the next frame would be on zero when we're looping, and this would be the 360 or the zero, in the frame zero. So you have a really flawless looping. Okay. And now let's, as I said, I make some frames a test render here if everything works fine. We have Octane here, so I say make all frames. I don't render all frames, I render 10 or 20 frames, and then we see if it works or not. Everything is okay here. And I don't use a denoiser here in this case. Let's render it. Yes, I don't mean. I don't use a denoiser here because the denoiser would eliminate my scratches here too. So this is not what I want. Now I see we have too much bump here for this HDRI. This is the next one. Every lighting works different. So, but if we can go easily down. Just want to see how it works now with the. But you see the 6 seconds or 5 seconds per frame. With 500 samples, and normally you do not really need more than 500 samples. You see how smooth it is with 500 samples, and here is no denoiser or something else. This is because we just worked nice. That's the only reason it looks so nice. But now I know that this is too many scratches. We can go down here, so. If we have too many scratches, just this float here, go down to, let's say, 0.3 maybe. So then we get less scratches. But for now, it's okay. Look at these wonderful colors here. This is just great. Honestly, I'm not really the RGB lover, because when I got my new RGB mainboard here, and then the first thing I did is deactivate everything. But here I like it. Yeah, definitely it works. See? The light moves, everything moves. And here on the floor, this looks nice too. Great, 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 great. I really love this one. So, okay, let's stop this. And I forgot one thing, the frame around. This makes it even a little different. So, we have this sweep here when we create it now. Of course, it covers our thing here. So, let's make what I did here is simple specular material. So, take a specular material. This is our frame, let's say. Okay. And here I did not much, so put it on here, sweep. It makes it a little different, but what I did is here I made a little scattering medium here. It's a little. Because you don't have to do this, is it? And you don't see much, but it makes a little difference. It's however you want. So this is how I did it. So this was my result. Then, yeah, that's it. Nice. We got a really nice one here, and 1.5 hours. That's okay. So okay, if you liked this, please thumbs up. If you don't like it, thumbs down, of course. And yeah, I wish you, it's almost over, but I wish you all a happy Easter still. And if you have questions, complaints, requests, please write me in the comments or somewhere in my Facebook group. And I'm always happy when I see some results you guys made. So please post it on my Facebook group. And yeah. Next tutorial will come, of course. I cannot say when, but now at the moment it starts to be more quiet, and I think I get more time to do something. And yeah, for what is to say? Yeah, if you want to donate, yeah, hey. I think that the people totally forgot to donate. It's not really heavy. Just click the link and choose what you wanna donate. Would be nice, because you see I don't have any sponsor or something else, and I don't do any commercial before my videos or something else, so I don't get any money for this, so I get money from the, yeah, if you wanna support me on Patreon, which I really really appreciate, and thanks in this way. Thanks to all my patrons. I really, really, really appreciate you. And yeah, and I am working on a tutorial, and a really nice tutorial for patrons only. So be patient a little bit and stay tuned. And there will come more for patrons only. And of course, the project files are just for patrons, and you can download them. And in the project file, as I said, there is the same thing is for the physical render, but of course in the physical render it needs longer to render. But you get almost the same result here. So. And yeah, Patreon would be nice, donation would be nice. And now, I wish you the best here from Vienna, and hope you like this one. For me, it was really fun. And maybe you show me your work and different logo styles or something else, or other weird object things here. And yeah, so hopefully see you soon. And hopefully you are with me in my next video. And have a wonder, wonder, wonderful day. Good. So, my last words every time, you know it, and then it's really over. The words are Tschüss und Baba.